step of the way, we walk the line. Your days are numbered, so are mine. Time is piling up, we struggle and we scrape. All boxed in, nowhere to escape. City's just a jungle, more games to play. Trapped in the heart of it, trying to get away. I was raised in the country, been working in the town. I've been in trouble since I set my suitcase down.
I have 1 pound of white turkey, 1 pound of dark meat turkey. Don't be afraid of the dark meat turkey. It's actually going to have better flavor, and that's what I'm going to use today. I'm going to save most. Making sausage is not hard. Sage. If you don't grow this, grow it. It'll last through the winter, and you'll have it. Same with rosemary. It's an evergreen, so you'll have that all around. These are the two main herbs we're going to use in this. And I've got like maybe 15 leaves of sage going right here. And you just want to maybe a little less rosemary than the sage. Just adding one clove of garlic. Of course, you got to salt stuff, so go ahead and add a little bit of pepper. So now, do you want a hot sausage or do you just want some flavor? Either way, use some red pepper flakes. But depending on how spicy you want it, depends on how many red pepper flakes. This is a raw sugar right here, which still has some of the molasses left in it because it's not been processed all the way. And there's a tablespoon of that. Now you could use another tablespoon of the raw sugar, or if you don't have raw sugar around and you have molasses around, you can use molasses. So I'm going to do half and half just to show you today. And honestly, I kind of like doing half and half as well. Here's the fun part. You're going to need these because the best way to put it all together is with your hands. Recipe cards, and this recipe for crepes actually goes back to my mom fixing them for my great-grandmother, who well into her 90s wouldn't eat anything, and until she found a peach crepe, and she loved them and she ate them a lot. So it's a real simple recipe. We're gonna make crepes for four people, so I'm gonna do four eggs today. These eggs have harder shells because they just came from the chicken. I usually get my eggs from my sister, Jennifer. So we have four eggs in there. And you gotta think, a pinch of salt per one, two, three, four. And then for each egg that we have in there, Again, that 4 tablespoons of flour, which if you want to make it a lot quicker, I've measured into like a packed 1/3 cup. All right, it's not going to stay that doughy because we're going to add milk to it. And for anyone who says you have to have cream in a crepe, no, I mean, get a little skinnier with it. This is 1% milk that I'm using. It's a 1/2 cup of milk for every egg. This recipe calls for 2 teaspoons of butter for every egg. Like I said, you can do a little bit less than that and still be fine, but it's melted butter you're looking for. Don't skimp, real butter, don't use margarine. We're gonna set it in the refrigerator to sit for a little bit. Some people say as long as an hour. Even as little as 10 minutes will help you out a lot. It's gonna get rid of the bubbles in the mixture so that your crepe batter doesn't have as many holes, not as likely to split on you.
Crepe fans.
I actually use a cast iron round grill. We've sprayed this, okay? So it's heated on, mine's on a low heat, but it's gas. And if you've got electric, you might wanna pump it up just a little bit higher than low. This, you want to hear a sizzle when this happens. You want to start seeing the smoke coming up, but not too much. And then all you're going to do is lift up some of your batter and put it down. Once all that batter has started to sit and you start to see a little bit of bubble coming up from the bottom, it's going to be where you can start to separate it. You see that? Having a good flipper, if you would, is really key. This is very flexible, thin, but it's long, so it holds about 1/2 crepe once you get it in it, and it's been my favorite. But you're gonna get underneath the crepe, lift it up, look at there, it sticks with you, and flip it over, just like that. From there, it's really, you almost don't need the flipper from there. And it'll take a lot less time on the second side than it did the first side. Slide right off. Plain peach, by the way, plain blackberry, plain blueberry is delicious. You can do a little bit of powdered sugar in there. And you're going to want to roll them like such. Add a few more strawberries. And I assure you, this little bit of powdered sugar is way less than any kind of syrup you'd put on a pancake. So that's our strawberry one ready to go. This next one, we're going to use that mascarpone cheese and goat cheese lemon mixture. It is so good, creamy. And we're going to do fig with this. We'll do the same fold with this one. Always fun to put on the top what you're eating. Everybody wants to know what they're having. Again, that little bit of powdered sugar, nothing to worry about.
I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. No, I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Well, I wake up in the morning, hold my hands and pray for rain. I got a head full of ideas that are driving me insane. It's a shame the way she makes me scrub the floor. Ah.